Hey folks, in a previous episode, I showed you how to use Cython's native mechanisms for performing operations in parallel. Now, I'm going to show you how those mechanisms can be used with NumPy arrays in Cython. Now, normally when you work with NumPy arrays, you want to do as much work as you can using NumPy's built-in broadcasting functions. So instead of iterating over each element in an array, you tell NumPy what to do with each element, and NumPy figures out the rest. But sometimes you do need to iterate over each element to do custom processing that can't be done entirely in NumPy. Cython lets us do all that iterating at C speed instead of Python speed. And depending on the work being done, we may be able to further speed up the processing by using parallelism, namely multithreading. However, you should be cautious of how much of a speed up you can expect to get because of the overhead that threading imposes. Now, to demonstrate how this works, I'm going to use an example that's been modified somewhat from Cython's own documentation. Now, in this project, I've got two incarnations of a Cython function, and both of them do the same thing. They take a 2D NumPy array, they iterate over its elements, they do some math on each element, and they return a new array of the same size with the results of that math. The second incarnation of this function has one significant change. It uses prange rather than range to iterate over the outer dimension of the array, and so allows that work to be done in parallel. This kind of a job is a good fit for a parallel operation because each row in that array can be processed in isolation. A couple of other things are worth noting here. When we want to work with a NumPy array in Cython, we use this special declaration syntax here to indicate what kind of array we're dealing with. So this particular syntax means an array of floating point doubles with two dimensions to the array. Now, when we do this, the result is a special type used in Cython called a memory view. And this lets us work directly with the underlying data in the array, and it further speeds things up. And to speed things up even further when working with the memory view, we can use a few Cython decorators to selectively toggle off some of the runtime checks performed when accessing the memory view. We know ahead of time how big our array is, so we can disable those checks at runtime and speed things up. If we don't provide this kind of specific typing, Cython will just assume that you're using a generic Python object, and the results are going to be no faster than if we'd written all of this in regular Python. So the key to unlocking the speed when working in Cython with NumPy arrays is to use the memory view syntax. This tells Cython to perform direct access to the underlying memory. Now, to invoke this code, I'm going to use some regular Python. And this code here creates a NumPy array of some defined dimensions. It fills it with random floats and then performs both the serial and parallel versions of the same function and times the results for each of those operations. And I've set this up so this code will get invoked using arrays of 100, 500, 5,000, and 10,000 elements on a side. And I'm going to run the 100 by 100 set three times to illustrate a point. Now, when we run this code, you're going to see we have four sets of results with different timings. The first run with the 100 by 100 array is done three times, and it shows that the parallel version of the function is much slower than the serial version, but only on its first run. This is because the setup process for a parallel operation itself has some overhead. We have to start the thread pool in the background and populate it. The other runs for the 100 by 100 array, they're a little bit better, but only somewhat. It's when we get into the bigger arrays that we start seeing markedly different results. And there, the parallel versions are typically running anywhere from 2 to 3 times as fast as the serial version. The results are going to vary depending on your workload. Now, here's the thing. I've got 6 physical cores in this system, so how come I'm not getting results 6 times as fast for the parallel version? Well, there's several reasons for this. One is that the work is already fairly fast, and so splitting the work across threads will incur overhead from threading that can offset some of the gains. And this isn't to say threading is going to be useless with NumPy arrays, only that the gains are not necessarily going to be absolutely linear with number of cores, depending on what the work is like. Now, if you have some idea of whether or not it's worth it to split up a NumPy workload into threads based on the size, you can add some conditional logic whether or not to use threads. There's an option for prange, it's not yet been merged into Cython's codebase though, that lets you control whether to use threads or not based on some existing condition. It's called use threads if, and it looks like this. Now in Cython 3.1, when that comes out, you'll be able to use this as a way to unify multi-threaded and single-threaded range loops, so you don't have to write multiple incarnations of the same function or roll your own decision logic for what kind of loop to use. But as of Cython 3.0, you still need to do that manually. So that's what we're doing here. So the key things to keep in mind while working with NumPy arrays in parallel. One, use proper types so that you're working with memory views derived from NumPy arrays and not generic Python objects. This is for the fastest possible access to the underlying data. Two, be mindful of the proper scenarios for using parallelism. Some operations don't start to scale until they reach a certain size because of the overhead of using threads. Three, be mindful of how, even with bigger jobs, the overhead of threading can make parallelism less effective than it could be ideally. This is something to be really mindful of when working with NumPy arrays. And finally, do all of the actual looping through your array in Cython itself. Minimize the number of times you call into your Cython function because every such call has overhead. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar in InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.